Welcome back. I'm in Jacksonville, Florida. 2 weeks ago, Hurricane Maria devastated Puerto Rican. Most gas stations and grocery stores are open, but the vast majority of homes still lack water or electricity. On Wednesday, the White House petitioned Congress to approve nearly $30 billion in and for those American states and territories hardest hit by the summer storms. This after self-sabotaging optics of President Trump's visit to Puerto Rico the day before, where he made comments perceived as playing up to the island's debt while playing down its human losses. Joining me now from Chicago is Illinois Congressman Luis Gutierrez. He's a son of Puerto Rican immigrants and has been visiting Puerto Rico. Congressman, thank you for being with me.
Thank you for having me, Reverend.
Congressman, your reaction to the president, the tweets before calling, in essence, Puerto Rican citizens ingrates and getting in a battle with the mayor of San Juan, and then his comments when he actually visited Puerto Rico this week.
Yes, well, you know, I think back to throwing paper towels at human beings. Now, maybe you throw peanuts at squirrels in the park and your ball to your dog to retrieve it, but certainly not human beings. It's part of the process of dehumanization that goes on under president. Now, I can think of a court jester or a clown in a circus might want to do something like that, but not the president of the United States. He should have come and shown empathy, something that he has such great difficulty. Although I have to say, I saw some of that, I believe it was real, in Las Vegas, but he couldn't do it in Puerto Rico. It always goes back, I think, to the start of his campaign, right? Mexicans are murderers, rapists. They're bad people. We need to get rid of them. And remember that in common modern political vernacular, right? Mexican means Puerto Rican, means Colombian, means Latino. And they're interchangeable. And I don't think he can quite, because, you know, he knows the island of Puerto Rico. He had a hotel. He had a golf course there. Trump International. Of course, there's $33 million in debt because it went bankrupt only after he charged millions of dollars in fee to put his name there. So look, Mr. President, it was a good enough place for you to come and play golf. Certainly it's a good enough place for you to help the people survive this tragedy. Now, here's the thing, Reverend. He said, well, I don't know if this was a real catastrophe. We are 18 days into this, and there are still people who have to look for food and water every day.
And they are American citizens. Let's emphasize that.
Not only that, I wish the president of the United States, who on four occasions says, well, I got bone spurs, so I can't serve in the armed forces of the United States, would spend one moment at the Vietnam Memorial before he ever thinks of Puerto Ricans again and see the hundreds of names that were lost and given up in the war in Vietnam of Puerto Ricans. So there were American citizens there. And they were ready to serve this nation, not only then, but in Korea and World War II and World War I. So you're right, Reverend. What are we going to say about a president who had some bone spurs but has found the ability to walk every golf course in the country when there are hundreds there in the Vietnam Memorial that he should be recognizing?
Well, thank you, Congressman Gutierrez. Keep on the fight.
Thank you.
I want to bring